Welcome to Understand the Math. This video is part of a series of videos on linear algebra and its applications and focuses on introductory concepts and example problems related to orthogonality. Be sure to check out the link below for free guided notes that you can highlight and fill in as you watch this video. Let's begin by talking about the inner product of two vectors. In Euclidean space, the inner product is called the dot product, and it's a scalar, which is just a single number. If we have two vectors u and v in R2, the dot product of these two vectors is just the corresponding components in u and v multiplied together and added. U dot v can also be written as u transpose v or as u times v transpose. We can also write the dot product of u and v in terms of the angle theta between u and v. The dot product is just the magnitude of u times the magnitude of v times the cosine of the angle between them. The dot product measures the extent to which two vectors point in the same direction. If the dot product is positive, that means that cosine of theta is positive, and theta is then an acute angle. In this case, the two vectors, u and v, point in a similar direction. If the dot product is equal to zero, then cosine theta is equal to zero, so theta must be equal to 90 degrees, and our two vectors u and v are perpendicular. If our dot product is negative, cosine theta is negative, and that means that theta is an obtuse angle. In this case, our vectors u and v point in very different directions. In Rn, the dot product is computed just like it is in R2, and u dotted with v is equal to u1 v1 plus u2 v2 all the way up to un vn. Each component of u is just multiplied by the corresponding component in v. We're now going to look at an example problem where we're given vectors u and v, and we're asked to find the dot product of u and v. To find the dot product, u dotted with v, we're just going to multiply the corresponding components. We're going to multiply 1 times 5, that's the first component, and then we'll multiply 3 times 1, that's the second component, and then we'll multiply negative 2 times negative 3. This gives us 5 plus 3 plus 6, so the dot product is equal to 14. Let's now quickly go over some algebraic properties of dot products. If u, v, and w are vectors in Rn, our first property tells us that u dotted with v is just equal to v dotted with u. This just means that it doesn't matter which order you do the dot product in. Our second property tells us that the dot product is distributive. Our third property tells us when you take the dot product of a vector with itself, it's always going to be greater than or equal to zero. That's because each component gets squared. Our fourth property tells us that the dot product of a vector with itself is equal to zero if and only if the vector is equal to zero. Let's now learn how to calculate the length of a vector and how to find a unit vector. The length of a vector, also called its magnitude, is the distance between the tail and tip of a vector. I've drawn a picture of a vector in R2, and its length or magnitude is denoted like this. You just place two bars on each side of the vector. Using the Pythagorean theorem, we can see that the magnitude of this vector v is just the square root of v1 squared plus v2 squared. In addition to being called the magnitude, the length of a vector can also be called the norm of a vector. The length of a vector is the square root of the dot product of the vector with itself, and it's just equal in Rn to the square root of v1 squared plus v2 squared all the way up through vn squared. The magnitude of a vector squared is just the dot product of the vector with itself. In applications, we'll often take the magnitude of a constant times a vector. And in those situations, it's best to pull out the constant as the absolute value of c and then multiply it by the length of vector v. This makes computations a lot easier. We're now going to look at an example where we're going to compute the length of a given vector v. We write the length of vector v as magnitude of v, and it's just the square root of each component of v squared. So we have 1 squared plus minus 2 squared plus 4 squared. This is equal to the square root of 1 plus 4 plus 16. This gives us a length equal to the square root of 21. Let's now talk a little bit about unit vectors. A unit vector is just a vector whose length is equal to 1. If we have a vector and we want to make it a unit vector, we go through a process called normalizing a vector. Our unit vector is just our vector v divided by its magnitude. When we normalize a vector, the length of the vector becomes 1 and its direction stays the same. This is often useful in applications where only the direction of the vector matters. We're now going to walk through an example where we want to find a unit vector in the direction of a given vector v. Let's begin by writing down our formula. Our unit vector we'll call u, and it's going to be equal to our vector v divided by the length or norm of vector v. Let's go ahead and compute that first. The length of vector v is just the square root of each component of v squared. So we have 6 squared, and then we have a minus 2 squared, and then we have 3 squared. This gives us the square root of 36 plus 4 plus 9. This is equal to the square root of 40 plus 9, so that's 49, and the square root of 49 is 7. To create our unit vector u, we're going to take every component in vector v and just divide it by 7. So we get 6 sevenths minus 2 sevenths and then 3 sevenths. Our vector u is now a unit vector with magnitude of 1. Let's now learn how to compute the distance between two vectors. In our picture here, we have two vectors u and v, and the distance between them is this dotted red line. To find this distance, I've drawn these same two vectors on the right and let w be the vector between them. If we add these vectors, we can see that v plus w is going to be equal to vector u. We can then solve for w and let it be vector u minus v. And that tells us that the length of vector w is just the length of vectors u minus v. This gives us a formula for the distance between two vectors u and v, and it's just the magnitude or length of u minus v. I've written this formula down below. The distance between u and v, just like we saw above, is the magnitude of u minus v, or we could have written our vector w in the upper right the opposite way, and that would have given us that the distance between u and v is the magnitude of v minus u. The formula for the distance between two vectors in Rn is just the square root of each of the corresponding components subtracted and then squared. We're now going to look at an example where we're going to find the distance between two vectors u and v. Let's start by writing down our formula. The distance between two vectors u and v is just equal to the square root of u1 minus v1 quantity squared plus u2 minus v2 quantity squared plus u3 minus v3 quantity squared. For our vectors u and v, we're going to have the square root of minus 1 minus 7 quantity squared. We're just taking each component and subtracting it. And then we have our next component subtracted. So that's going to be 3 minus 1 squared. And then our last components, 2 minus 5 squared. This gives us the square root of minus 8 squared plus 2 squared plus minus 3 squared. If we multiply these terms out, we're just going to get the square root of 64 plus 4 plus 9. And that's just equal to the square root of 77. So the distance between vectors u and v is the square root of 77. We're now going to learn how to determine if two vectors are orthogonal. Orthogonal vectors are vectors that are perpendicular to each other and whose dot product is equal to zero. Let's look real quick to see why the dot product is equal to zero. It's defined as the magnitude of u times the magnitude of v times the cosine of the angle between them. When two vectors are perpendicular, the angle between them is 90 degrees, and the cosine of 90 degrees is equal to zero, which makes the dot product equal to zero. If two vectors are orthogonal, they are also linearly independent, and that's because they don't point in the same direction and they're not multiples of each other. Let's now look at an example where we're asked to determine if the following pairs of vectors are orthogonal. In our first example, we have two vectors and they each have two components. To determine if they're orthogonal, we're going to take their dot product. So u dotted with v is going to be minus 8 times 2 plus 5 times 3. And that gives us minus 16 plus 15, which is equal to minus 1. The dot product is not equal to 0, so we say that u and v are not orthogonal. Let's now look at our second example. Our vectors u and v have three components in them. We're going to do the same thing that we did above. We're going to start by calculating the dot product of u and v. So we'll multiply the corresponding components. We'll multiply minus 12 times minus 2, and then we'll add minus 3 times 3. And then we'll add 5 times minus 3. This gives us 24 minus 9 minus 15, and that gives us a value of 0. Because the dot product is equal to 0, we can state that u and v are orthogonal, which means they're perpendicular to each other. Be sure to check out the next video in this series where I'll teach you all about orthogonal sets of vectors and orthogonal projection. If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.